Yes, people. So we're going to talk about how to play as a striker in non-league football. Let's go. For me, possibly the hardest position to play at non-league due to the pressure to be able to convert and score and make your chances is possibly the striker position. I haven't played there as a centre forward for a few clubs, one being Tower Hamlets, Basingstoke. I played there. Who else? A few others. And I'm telling you now, like, it's probably one of the toughest positions. Simple fact that because if you're not banging in goals, you get dropped immediately. There isn't no restitution. It's an immediate drop after a few games, or the manager's bringing somebody else to score goals and they're going to get paid a higher wage. It's just as simple as that. That's how it goes. So for you guys going into non-league football as a striker, one of the things that will get the attention of the gaffer and even other clubs higher is, number one, is goals. So typically, when I did my research and looking at how many goals or what type of goals are scored at non-league level, the majority of goals scored at non-league level will be coming in a 1v1 situation, meaning high line, through ball. And that's the thing as well, if you're off the ball movement, if you see here in this video, if you're off the ball movement here is spot on, that you can play on the shoulder of the defender, arguably not down the middle, you know, any side of the ball's on this side here, like so, you know, at either side of your here, that's even better because you could just, it's a simple run, or you can do those ones to bend across, but you have to have good movement off the ball to get yourself in a 1v1 situation, which happens a lot of times at non-league level. Obviously, the higher it gets, most teams more disciplined in their line, but majority of goals come from 1v1 situation. The next goals, according to the stats that showed, is tap-ins. So you have to be greedy. I remember when I went to Australia, I scored in the NPL, I think my first 3-4 games, when I scored 2 each game, were all tap-ins. And I'm not, I don't know, people could call me a tap-in merchant. I just said, you know what, I worked out how it worked over there and the system that I was able to score goals in, and I found out tapping in the ball, running the box late, movement off the striker, behind the striker, worked. So the striker, the ball's coming here across like this, I'll just peel off. I worked out how to peel off, and because I studied a lot of videos on Aubameyang as well when he was at Dortmund, who was prolific at that. The next area of development you must have to play in non-league as a striker successfully is the ability to be physical. Now, if you haven't got the speed, then you need to compensate the speed with physicality. I mean, you need to be wedge. I'm not talking about physically muscles out your eyeballs. I'm just saying that you need to be able to know how to use your body very well, which is why a lot of teams in non-league football have the big man up top to flick the ball down, to knock ons here, etc., etc., etc. And that, yeah, so physically you need to, I remember, especially when the ball's in these sort of pockets here, so typically the movement usually happens when, because a lot of centre backs at non-league, if you've played there, will break lines like this, and that ball coming in from this centre back here, you need to be able to stick that, hold that, and be able to set it off to the 10. If you are not able to hold up the ball, and obviously you can see the clips of me playing Tower Hamlets, that's the majority of the stuff that I had to do to be able, because the way that we played, you need to be able to hold up the ball. If you can't hold up the ball, then you need to be able to be very good running off of it. But most strikers need a strike, most teams, sorry, in non-league like a striker that can hold up the ball very well. If you could do that, again, you could watch many videos such as Didier Drogba, you know, many guys, Olivier Giroud, very good at holding up the ball, Lukaku, you know, all those guys. And next thing as well, leading up to that, as I finish, is the aerial threat. Yeah, even someone said to me, oh, but Prince, I can't jump higher. I said, even if you have to jump up just to put up the centre back, it's everything, because the ball is going to get lumped up field. And most teams require a striker that's very good aerially to knock the ball down, flick on from strikers, etc. here. So flick on there, 10 can run into it, etc. like that. You need to be able to be good in the air. Even if you can't win the aerial duel against your centre back, you need to be able to jump. So let me know in these areas Like I said, let's tick it off. Goals, you need to be able to be 1v1, off the ball movement, you need to crash the box. Physicality, if you ain't got the physicality, then you need to have speed to run off the shoulder. That's an asset. If you need to have aggression to be able to hold up the ball, no matter what, if you're a false nine, whatever, you got to hold up the ball. And the last one as well, you need to have aerial threat. Even if you can't win the headers, just jump. Let me know what you think about this, and let's go.